So you don't have a problem with, because you know it's slim picking, so majority of the men that you might be looking for is married. So the chances are you might be married into a, somebody that's
but, but now where I'm at now, I think I would probably have to be the first one. Because in dealing with that throughout time and throughout the years, people wise haven't given me a hard way to go. They've been giving me trouble. And then I feel like that's where you say to myself, people are like, forget it. Because the wives might be like, they with it. And then, you know, once you start talking to the person, now that wife is talking to the new mother-in-law to tell her negative things about you. So now you're going to come in, and now your mother-in-law ain't really too crazy about you. She might, you know, like, it just be little stuff like that. You be like, hold up. Or, like, I remember I was pursuing one brother, or we were talking, and when I went to Muslim Day at Great Adventure and almost got into a fight with the sister's daughter. Because, you know, the sisters, whatever her feelings are, she having conversations with her daughter about what she feels. So now the daughter come walking up to me. I got my little child with me. And she like, you disrespecting my mother? And she all like this in my face, you know, in my space and wanting to be confrontational. And it could have easily turned into a fight.
Yeah.
And I'm just trying to de-escalate it because I have my daughter here with me. But whatever the mom told her child, it makes her child now, who was like a small adult, I think her child was maybe like 19 or something. Her child now wants to be confrontational with that child because no child want to hear that their mom or whatever was being disrespected, right? Yeah. So now look at that. And all of this is because of what? And he couldn't control the situation. The man, he can't do nothing about this whole thing. The whole thing's like spiraling out of control. So with certain things like that, where I'd be like, okay, forget it. Or you get certain situations where a man had his family with him and they got children and they had something. And then when he trying to move with you, when she getting her feelings, she go, y'all just go ahead and be happy. And I'm going to just take my kids and do, and it's down a guilt trip. And not only the guilt trip, but like, now I gotta look and say, I don't want the community now looking bad at me. Like, I'm messed up.
I gotta do a home record something.
Right. Yeah. They don't look at it like that because y'all solid and been solid for a whole lot of years. 10, 8, 10, 12. What I'm supposed to do now? Now they gonna be all giving me when I try to show up for E. So it's stuff like that where you be like, you know what? Women may say that they want it, and sometimes once it start happening in their face, sometimes they waver and be different. Sometimes you got wives who try to spin up or use most of the money up. So now he can't, he have nothing to really give you or do for you. Cause now she start coming with extra expenses. She want a house now all of a sudden. Y'all had a little condo or y'all had a little co-op or whatever. And what y'all had was cool. She start thinking real big. Hold up. You want to get you another wife? We need a new car. For our family, or they go and they, you know, they want to get pregnant. Yeah. That's a new expense. Children cost money, or things like that.
Yeah, so yeah. So what happened? That first wife started causing a bunch of aggravation and scare.
Yeah, I had one wife tell me that I couldn't be her co-wife because she can't have a co-wife that's as cute as her. Like, I guess she had to be cuter than the one who was going to be. Like, she had to be the cutest one, not one as equally cute. Or
but that's a compliment, though, right?
Yeah, but no, because eventually I can't get in because you feeling some kind of way. You cute, so why we both can't be cute? Why you getting your tattoo cute red bone so wild?
Because she sees you as like, more beautiful.
So it's just stuff. So I don't know. I'm not really looking for that right now. And that happens before.
All
right,
now let me ask you a question. All right. Do you ever pop in your mind, because this is what I be hearing a lot, that you would consider marrying somebody that's not Muslim?
There's a lot of women.
Yeah, why aren't you married? They can't find a man like how you just described. So they like, listen, I'm about to go marry a non-Muslim.
But that doesn't work for me. They're never interested really in converting. It never appears sincere. But for some reason, they always feel like we just gonna coexist as who we are. So I'm not lucky in that area. Other women have been lucky to get the men to be sincere or to want to do it for them. Alhamdulillah for that. I wish that it worked like that for me because there's such a shortage and because I find that the non-Muslim men are also more willing. Like, you're not having the same argument, dowry argument with non-Muslims. So even though they don't know, If you say to them, look, I want to get a, you know, I want a ring, they'll just be like, cool, when you want to go to the mall and look at rings, or
the niggas don't even want to buy a ring.
Yeah, but when you get with a non-Muslim, but if you with a Muslim guy and you say like a ring, first thing he gonna say, you want to imitate in kufar? You want a ring? We look at that, and that's the first thing he wanna say, so he can have a reason not to get you a ring. Or he might say, oh, you want a ring? So, and then I had one brother ask me if he could give me a Cuban zirconia until he could get me the real thing. And I'm like, why would you want to give me a cubic? Like, I don't know. I feel like it's one thing if someone say, I can only get you this really little thing right now and I'll upgrade you later. But to start off with a cubic, I just feel like you just disrespectful. So Muslim brothers sometimes they trick that way. Whereas with the non-Muslim, he'll just be like, yo, so, when you want to go, we go look at the stuff. And go to the mall, you try the stuff on, and it's like, okay, but, and they'll think something in their head, but, they don't be open to the conversion, and they don't want it, and that's a problem, and I see it as a problem, so I can't be like, in the headlights, like, we don't see it. No, we know what you're saying. Some people, we want to say they spiritual. Other people, I don't believe in organized religion, all of that. Okay, I get the hint, I'm not slow. I caught it. My elevator go all the way up. I heard it. And that is what I have to go off of that and deal with that. And if they, you know, I had the Jehovah's Witness. He was like crazy with me. And that's why he's not like even my friend, because he was so like in love with me and he liked me so much. And he just kept feeling like we could be coexisting. Like he just was like, he didn't see the problem. And I'm like, hold up. Let me get this straight. I'm like, when we have kids, our kids will go to the Kingdom Hall and the mosque.
Yeah. Like the Kingdom Hall, they would not tolerate.
Like the kids is gonna go to Kingdom Hall and the mosque. My kids are gonna do E and that other thing, and they're gonna do this and like it's just so much. So I don't know how he thought that was supposed to work. And sometimes people feel like, and then it's like I would have to do too much changing, because when you meet the average non-Muslim, sometimes they eat pork. Sometimes people don't want to get rid of the pork, or that, even if they do, they got like the alcohol thing going, it'd be Cinco de Mayo, and they want to have a little drinky drink, and tequila's on sale, shots for free, or whatever. And it even like, hold up, I gotta come in, I gotta tell you, no, we can't do this, and the people are like, what happened to taking me as I am? Well, why are you trying to change me? People don't want, men don't like that, especially. So, with a non-Muslim, you gotta do a lot of changes, unless they already in order. Unless they already got a certain diet, already got a certain lifestyle, already
they gotta be interested in the same.
Yeah.
On their own. You can't try to.
I remember one time, I was talking to one guy, he was a non-Muslim, and he was interested. He came to the mosque. He was doing the whole thing. And was like, I don't remember if he had such a high or not. I just knew that he was really getting involved in it or whatever. And he was doing it for me. You can tell. Then his mom had gotten cancer. Mm-hmm. And then he was all with the... See, I know Allah's not real, because then he wouldn't... when they gave my mom the cancer, like my mom would have... You know, and then he started talking crazy. And then I was like, see, this is a problem. Because... when you have that belief, you understand it, a few things. You understand it, that you are tested and you're going to be tested with life, health, wealth, children, all nine. You know that this life is a test. You also know from an Islamic perspective that Allah tests those who He loves. Boom. You know from an Islamic perspective, Allah is not going to put nothing on you that you can't bear. Boom. You also know that sickness is expiation for sins. Which we all got those. Mm-hmm. Some of us be wishing to be sick. Or when we be sick, not like to the point where we dying, but some of us, when we get a cold, we be like, mashallah, these are expiation. Why is this joint off? And you get, you know, excited because you know that you need that, because you know you're not 100%
doing this stuff.
So all of that is like, you know, it was like, wow, he said that. And then, you know, things start falling apart. So the non-Muslim thing is really not working.